What's up, dudes? Do a little review here over the Chris Reeve Knives Nandi. All right. So I was just kind of in the market for a smaller knife and was definitely looking for something higher end, you know, and just kind of got it down to a few knives, like the 21 Sabenza, you know, the small 21 Sabenza. Maybe considering another PT. I have had a few of those, but and I also have had a Nandi before. I have not ever owned a classic or small 21, though. But anyhow, I kind of settled on an Nandi, give it a second shot, and also I just kind of, I feel like it's a little bit better of a value buy, you know, because it is a Chris Reeve, you know, it's really, really high quality. Plus, there are some upgrades that you get. You know, it's kind of, and price-wise, it's in between the small 21 and the small wood 21, you know. Those are 330 and 400, this is 350. And I just, aesthetically, this is seems like a nicer knife to me than the split down the middle of the 21 woods. I really kind of just like this, the one piece on the Nandi. Alright, so I kind of chose this instead. Plus, I just feel like it has a few other appointments that are just totally worth it. Such as, like the really large titanium pivot, you know, with the CR in it. Anodized blue and stuff. And then you get the pivot bushing, or whatever you call that, kind of circle around the screw there. That's also titanium. Pretty cool. And then the clip. You know, the clip on the Nandi is just a work of art in itself. You can see they're totally three-dimensionally milled out of titanium. Really super nice. They're really elegant, simple, and over the top, in my opinion, as far as a lot of the examples of clips go that you see out there, right? And then also you just get other appointments that are, you know, on all Chris Reeve knives. But just the attention to detail is phenomenal, you know, like how the tang is rounded off there, really nice, totally unobtrusive. Like some of the William Henrys, you know, the tang is kind of sharp and sticks off in this area. I'm not a huge fan of that. I feel like it's, you know, this is a shining example of why something like that is not necessary. And is also, in my opinion, a cut corner. So, yeah. So that's kind of why I chose it over some of the competition. All right. Also, you know, for such a small knife, very thick frame lock on here, titanium frame. And it's really nicely finished on there. Got the bead blast around the sides and then polished around where the sides of the slabs around where the wood is. Really nice. Alright. So that was kind of why I chose this guy. Alright. It is a little on the small side. But of course, you know that going into it. Not a lot smaller than a small Sabenza though. So, you know, maybe slightly trade-off there, but not so much. The handle shape is really well thought out, also in my opinion. It seems to fit really well, fit the hand really well. Like the distance between, you can see those two scoops here, between the two for these two fingers is more than, say, the regular small Sabenza. So it fits the hand really well in a three or even four finger grip. I kind of just let the pinky chill and hold it with more of a three finger grip. All right. So, yeah. Of course, lockup. Ideal on this guy. Perfectly centered blade, of course, what you get with Chris Reeve knives, you know, one of the big deals. The blade sits really far into the handle also. Just, I'm a big fan of that. Yeah, no corners cut here, you know, and for the 350, considering the other high-end offerings, I mean, this is just a real, real piece of work here, in my opinion. So, let's see, what else can I say about this guy? The, of course, you know, you get all the different premium woods with Chris Reeve knives. And this one is the Lignum Vitae, or however you say that. Basically, doing a little research on it, as far as I can tell, it is the hardest of the woods, coming in at over 3 times harder than oak. And, you know, the grain is so tight on it, you can't even really see any pores on it. It's really nice, which is exactly kind of what I was looking for. So it's so tight and hard that they still to this day use it in the bearings for submarines. I don't know why, but that's kind of just some of the research that I found about this wood. So that's really, really cool. Seems to me like it's just not going to be a problem under any circumstances. So knocking it around, being wet, stuff like that. It's going to be, you know, totally awesome. So I'm really psyched about that. Of course, the nail nick, I guess what you call it, a thumb nick, because it really is kind of a big enough to open with your thumb, is awesome. You know, it works totally well. I'm not a huge fan. That was another reason why I picked this over the Sabenza or the 21, was because I like that thumb nick on there. And the thumb lug just kind of seems to be, it can sometimes get in the way of cutting. You know, you'll go to cut some cheese and there'll be a big hunk of cheese on the thumb nick. Thumb lug, that is. And I'm sure this will probably catch some of that stuff too, but I like it. Also, you can do the Spidey drop with this guy, you know? Can't really do that with the Sabenza unless you really practice a lot, I imagine. But, so that was another reason why I picked it. I'm a big fan of Spyderco and super psyched about the ability to do that. All right, that's just me, you know, Captain Dick around here. But anyway, of course, you know, jewel, just incredible jewel-like finish, you know. Look at those, the jimping there, amazing quality. So, yeah. I'm going to do a little slideshow for you guys. Got some good comments when I did that a couple of times. So check that out. Thanks for watching. And palabra a tu madre.